Waler Horse Society of Australia was formed in 1986, and it was really brought about because of a fear that the original Waler horses would be lost. There was quite a lot of culling going on at that time, so quite a bit of research was done into stations around the Northern Territory, and horses were sourced to start breeding programs. One of the aims of the Waler Horse Society of Australia is to promote and educate the public about the breed. The fact that Equitana has taken on the challenge to do that as well is something we really couldn't have dreamed of. We've hoped for years to get the recognition of these horses, and the fact that Equitana recognises the value of these horses and is willing to start a project such as this is really a dream come true. The Walers in the war played a very vital role as mounted infantry. It's believed around 160,000 were shipped over for World War I. Walers also played a very important role in the Boer War, World War I, and then also World War II. After the war, only one horse came back, and that was Sandy. It's believed that around 13,000 were left after World War I. 11,000 of those were resold, typically into the British Army. However, a number of those which were either injured or of age were destroyed, unfortunately. The qualities of a Waler horse is, they've got to have a good solid foot, starting with. No foot, no hoof, no horse. Open foot, short cannons, flat knees, a strong shoulder, usually quite a short back, a very powerful high quarter, a good set of the neck, a great walk. They're known for their walking, certainly in the war, their walk rather than a trot, which would damage equipment and they would become unsound, so their ground covering walk was certainly very valuable for that purpose and has continued to be. Also a very good eyes, open nostrils, and a lovely temperament really is something that sets them apart. Once we've identified suitable areas to access Walers from, we then work with some very talented people in the territory who capture those horses in quite a humane way and are very experienced with transporting those. And then we try to find homes for them which know how to take on a horse like this. They can be a wonderful horse, but we have to understand that they are a wild animal, so they do need someone with experience. And then we go through a classification process through the association where we confirm the background and then also classify them on their type.
My main goal is to get as many domesticated as you can. But there used to be 60,000 horses on indigenous lands, and when you see them shooting them out, which hasn't happened in the last decade at least, it was cruel, and we decided that we'd just truck as many as we can and use them, either domesticate them or use them as a commodity. Like your days of your old stockmen, they're basically gone. Earlier on, they were run on horseback into quiet horses, into yards. Then it went from motorbikes into quiet horses, which are called coaches, into yards. Then you've gone into helicopters, which I don't like to use because it knocks the horse about too much. Or you use what you call a bayonet trap in the hot weather where they walk in. These bayonets are not sharp, but they can't walk out them. And all these horses here were baned or spear trapped. And that's how we caught them, yeah.
Equitana have designed a program to take on six horses. One of those horses will go into dressage. Another one into barrel racing, reining, harness, trick riding, and showing. So what we're really demonstrating there is that horses that have come from the same background and the same environmental conditions have the versatility to then go on into those different fields. The public will be able to see these horses in 2013 at the Sydney Equitana.